Why don't you step it up and go, Don?
Well, I'm going to if you'll let me.
I absolutely will let you.
Okay. So I'm going to do the first song that I ever recorded with the Maddox Brothers Rose, and that was about 1947, and it's called Step It Up and Go. This is an A.
Wabash Cannonball this way.
to have you here tonight.
Well, thank you.
How many of you guys are huge Maddox Brothers and Rose fans? Come on, Dallas.
Well, I didn't think anybody would remember the Maddox Brothers Rose because we were hot in the 40s and 50s. And the band broke up in about 1955, I think. And Rose and Cal and Mama went to the Grand Ole Opry and left me sitting there in Hollywood all by myself, and I couldn't play fiddle good enough to get a job with another band. So I'd always wanted to be a cowboy, and there was a college of agriculture down there in the San Fernando Valley. So I enrolled in the college of agriculture for 2 years, but I finished 2 years in 1 year. And then I came up to Ashland, Oregon, and bought a ranch, and I've been ranching up there ever since.
Now, you got a song you're going to sing next that's kind of the story of the Maddox Brothers and Rose. It's called $35 and a Dream.
How did you know that?
Well, I looked at the list.
Oh. Well, he's right. My family were sharecroppers in Alabama in the Great Depression. Not this one, the one back in 1950. So, my mother should always heard of California. I was 10 years old at that time. And my mother, she heard of California being the Golden State. And she wanted to go to California and find the gold and them hills that she'd heard so much about. So, they sold all their worldly possessions. This was in Alabama. And they got $35 for all their worldly possessions. And Mama and Papa and five kids started hitchhiking from Alabama to California. And we got as far as Meridian, Mississippi, and we stayed all night at the Salvation Army place. And there was a young couple in there that just struck up a conversation with my mother and father and said, "You'll never get to California walking." Said, "Why don't you ride the freight trains?" Well, they didn't know nothing about riding the freight train. So they said, "Well, we'll show you how," because that was a couple that had been riding the freight trains. And in those days, everybody rode the freight train because they didn't have anybody for cars and gas and so on and so forth. So we caught the freight train the next day. They showed us how to get on there. And we rode the freight train to California. And we ended up at Bakersfield there. And then we went to Southern California, and then on up to the coast, and then went up to Tualatin, California, which was the gold country then. And come to find out, everybody had already panned out all of the gold, and so to make a long story short, it's too late now. Well, anyhow, I'm going to do some... $35 on the green?
Yes, sir.
Well, that's what they got for their worldly possession. So some people wrote a song, and it's called $35 on the green, and this is in the key of G, I think.
Yeah.
That's it. Hang on, it goes.
Mama said, "I think it's time to..."
George's Playhouse Boogie.
George's Playhouse Boogie. I got to look and see the phone here first. George's Playhouse Boogie. Well, oh yeah, there it is. When we was playing on the radio station at Modesto in about 1950, well, we was playing on Friday nights at a beer joint up in Stockton, and the place was named George's Playhouse, and so I wrote a song about it called George's Playhouse Boogie, so I'm going to do that now.
Bunyan love.
Let me look at my I'll help.
Okay.
Oh, apartment here in do High Desert Waltz. If you didn't know, they do have a high desert up in Oregon where I came from. Up around there. And this is a key of D. And I'll take a short intro. I forgot how to go with them. I'm getting to the age where I'm getting senile and I can't remember anything. And I went to the doctor the other day to get a physical exam. And I told him I was getting to where I couldn't remember anything. And he said, I forgot what he said. So I'm 93 years old. And I just got a new child bride. She's only 75 years old. I said, I don't remember. I said, I'll ask my wife. She's out in the waiting room out there. So I went out there and I said, Barbara, the doctor wants to know if we have intercourse. She said, I've told him a dozen times the only thing we have is Blue Cross and Medicare. So I took the stage name of Don Juan, I thought if they thought I was a fella, well, they would come on to me, and I wouldn't have to come on to them. And that didn't work, so... I wrote a song about it, and it leads in the Orange Blossom Special, and this is in the key of E. Hey! Thank you.
record that was the song title, The Death of Rock and Roll.
Well, no, I did that on the stage with the Maddox Brothers rolling, and it went over real big. But the way I done it, I thought I did a terrible job of it, so I named the song The Death of Rock and Roll from the way I done it, and then made a big hit instead of being the death rock. We got rock and roll now all over. So I've got to play it for you, and it goes,
Ladies and gentlemen, Don Maddox. We're so honored to have you here, sir.